Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Lisa, if you're new here, and in today's video, as you guys can see from the title, I'm going to be covering how to wash your face properly at night, especially if you wear makeup or skincare. So that should be everyone, right? Because if you don't wear makeup, then I hope you wear skincare. And then I will be going through my extensive cleansing oil review. So the thing is, the first part of the video is about how to wash your face, and I'm sure a lot of people already use the two-step cleansing method. I feel like I'm just leaving this part here anyway for the people who don't know. / the people who don't wash their face this way, then hopefully I can convert you. But if you already are familiar with this method, feel free to skip ahead in the video. I will leave a timestamp here for you guys to see where the cleansing oil review starts. For everyone else who isn't aware of this method or haven't started, this honestly has been around for quite a while now, but part of the reason why I thought this was still important is because I recently was talking to my friend and she heavily inspired this video, so thank you, Leisha. But essentially, after talking to her, I realized that it is still important to cover it for those people who aren't aware of it yet. So basically, the two-step cleansing method, this is mostly for at night because I feel like for morning, you can just use your regular face wash and that's fine, but at night, you are coming off of a day probably wearing makeup, probably still have your skincare on. So this particular method I feel like is extremely, extremely effective and important and also just great for your skin to be washing it this way. So the first part of the double cleanse method is to use a cleansing oil to remove your makeup and also your skincare. And the reason why you want to use a cleansing oil as opposed to some other methods, for example, like the solutions where you have to pour in a cotton pad to remove or even makeup wipes, the reason why cleansing oil are preferable and also why I haven't used anything else for years except for the occasional time. But from an everyday perspective, I will always use a cleansing oil. And this is because number one, it is actually so much more gentler on your skin. So to give you an example, when you use a makeup wipe and you rub off your mascara, I feel like that process, back when I used to have an eye makeup remover, that was always so rough on my skin, particularly because of the cotton pad. And I guess the fibers on the cotton pad, it would be rubbing against my eyelids and also my eyelashes, and the mascara gunk would then also rub against my eyes. I just always found that entire process super unenjoyable. On top of that, I hated that feeling of the tackiness that your skin feels after you use it. So after I discovered the cleansing oil method, and I first discovered it, I believe in 2013 or 2014, I haven't switched back ever since. That is just one of the first reasons why you should be converting to cleansing oil. The second reason is because it's actually a lot more environmentally friendly. By using this method, you aren't using any more individual throwaway wipes and you're also not using any cotton pads. And then the last reason is because it's actually a lot more cost effective. When I was in university, and this is when I first discovered the cleansing oil method, because I was a broke ass student, I remember when I first bought my cleansing oil, and this was the first cleansing oil that I've ever purchased by Amore Pacific. I will go into the review a little bit later. Essentially, when I first bought the cleansing oil, this cleansing oil was not cheap. I think back then, maybe it was around $55. Present day, it is $65. But even at $55, I just remember thinking to myself, like, oh my God, who am I? Like, why do I deserve a $55 face wash? I am 20 or like 19 or something like that. So I was using the Neutrogena face wipes, and after doing the math, I even was so frugal with my Neutrogena face wipe, I would actually rip it in half and use it the next day. So I would use only half a day. So even at that calculation, I calculated how many makeup wipes I would need, and I also calculated how many bottles I was going through. So I was going through about one bottle every 6 months, and after doing the math, it ended up being around the same price. I think this was maybe slightly bit more, or maybe it was cheaper. I can't remember, but I just remember being so astonished with the results that I was just like, you know what? I'm just gonna use this from now on because it smells better and I just like it better. It doesn't have that tackiness feeling. And then also it's so much more gentle on your eyes. Going on to the specifics of the first step and how to use a cleansing oil, if you guys don't know how, is you actually start off by having clean, dry hands. So not wet hands, but also not dirty. Don't just put your cleansing oil on your hand, okay, make sure you wash it and then dry it properly. Because you are gonna be rubbing your eyes. You first clean and dry your hands, then you put the cleansing oil in your hand. I find that for every different cleansing oil, the pumps kind of change. I'm not able to just be like, you need two pumps or whatever. This also depends on how much makeup you have or if you're only just removing skincare. Once again, I'm not gonna tell you, but I would just say less is more. Always start off with a little bit, and then if you find out that you need to add more, then keep on adding more. But essentially, you put it on your skin, you rub it all over your hands, then you rub it all over your face. When you're rubbing it all over your face, this is when, by the way, there's absolutely no water at this point, okay? As you're rubbing the oil through your face, what I like to do, especially when it comes to the eyes, I like to just use my ring finger to kind of rub all the eye makeup off. When it comes to mascara, and this is the best part of this whole routine, because you're not having, you know, the fabric or like the cotton pad rubbing against your eyelashes and stuff, so you can easily actually use your fingertips and kind of like rub your eyelashes, and that's how I dissolve my mascara. So I'll use my ring fingers and I'll first dissolve it like this, and then I'll use my hands and kind of rub it all together. After you do that, that's when you start putting the water and you can start rinsing it off. And the best part is, most of these cleansing oils, after you do that, that's pretty much all you need. It acts also as a face wash, and this is why it ended up being cheaper, because when I was doing the calculation for the Neutrogena wipe alone, obviously it would be more expensive to buy a bottle of cleansing oil, but because every single makeup wipe I would require another face wash because it would make my skin feel really oily and stuff, so I had to also take into consideration my face wash. For actually many years, I only did a one-step cleanse, which is only using the cleansing oil. I think by using that actually could be good enough. You just need to spend a lot more time doing that rubbing phase of removing your makeup and using enough to make sure all the makeup comes off. A lot of the times I don't even need the second step because sometimes there aren't even any more residue afterwards. So if you want to be extremely cost saving, I think that just the first step personally could be enough. I think over the years, in the last 2 or 3 years, I have actually started incorporating the second step. So the second step isn't something I'm gonna review today in terms of the face washes, but I do wanna quickly mention what the second step entails. So the second step, you are either using a micellar water or you're using just a regular face cleanser. So for the regular face cleanser, I would say just having your typical face cleanser, something that's soapy, that's fine. So right after you use that, you can throw in a little bit of soap and foam and then get rid of any type of excess. Or the second one is, which is what I typically use, is micellar water. If you guys don't know what micellar water is, it honestly just looks like water. This is the only bottle I have here, but it honestly just looks like water. You can see the consistency, the color, and everything is pretty much water. The magical part of this is when you put it on your cotton pad, whether it's reused or the one-time use ones, I now have reusable ones, you can remove any extra makeup or skincare or whatever on top of what you've already removed to make sure it's even more clean. And after that step, then you just rinse your face off with water. So typically, I actually, especially now that I'm in Vancouver and this is the only little bottle that I brought, my second step has just been a regular face wash because I actually realized that, number one, it's more environmentally friendly since I don't have my reusable cotton pads here. I only brought the one-time use ones while I'm traveling, but I didn't know I was gonna say hear this long. So I've been using just a regular face wash, and also if you don't want to spend the money on buying another product, which is micellar water, you can just use your morning face wash as a second step. And that's also, once again, if you want to do the two-step. A lot of people recommend it. Personally, like I said, I went like 4 or 5 years with just using the one step, and if you find a really good cleansing oil, then it should actually already remove pretty much everything. That's pretty much the thoughts that I have on washing your face. This section ended up being a lot longer than I thought, but I hope this was helpful, and I hope that if you guys are using makeup wipes or whatever it is time to switch it up for your everyday routine. And don't get me wrong, this is not a video hating on makeup wipes or anything. In fact, I do have makeup wipes. I even brought it here just to show you and prove to you guys that I still use makeup wipes. It's just the occasion of when I use makeup wipes is way less now, and also it depends on the situation. For makeup wipes, I'll bring the one-time use ones. I'm not even in a big packet, but like the one-time Neutrogena ones, I'll bring it on if I'm going on a plane, if I want to remove my makeup on there, because there's no way I can be splashing my face with water. So in certain situations, the makeup wipes are still really important. I also have makeup wipes to help me remove some of my eyelash curler stuff. Like, I do still always have a pack of makeup wipes, but for my everyday evening removing my makeup, this is now my go-to using cleansing oils. And like I said, I feel like it is such a large part of my routine. It is something that you use every day. Even if you don't wear makeup, the reason why this is still important is because your sunscreen or even some of the lotions from your makeup, just water is not gonna remove it. It is still important to sort of have like an oil-based type of remover on you, even if you're not really wearing makeup, or at least using a micellar water to remove your skincare and stuff like that. So anyway, that was pretty much part one of the video. I'm now gonna go into my favorite cleansing oils and kind of doing a more extensive review. So if you guys watch my foundation review, this is gonna be sort of the same way I'm going to be reviewing the micellar water. I will be talking about price a lot because honestly, you guys, I feel like even if I was ever the richest woman on earth, or if my sugar daddy was Jeff Bezos, I feel like I will still care about the quality of the product and how much it is and which one is more worth it, because at the end of the day, sometimes it's not about the product. Sometimes it is about the principle, okay? Like, your hard-earned money is going towards these products, so you wanna give it to a brand that is worth it, okay? So even if you do have a sugar daddy, you worked for that sugar daddy, okay? So you gotta like use the money wisely on a product that is worth it. But anyway, that's my little rant. So I feel like prices will always be included in any of my reviews. But anyway, I'm just gonna go right into the cleansing oil review. Basically, as I prefaced in the beginning part of this video, I have used 9 different cleansing oils. Here alone in Vancouver, and this is not even my primary residence, I have 3 in my home right now in Toronto. I have 4 different ones. So that is already 7, and then 2 of them I have finished and now I have to basically review it off memory. But basically, I'm pretty confident that I am a pretty reliable person for this review. The few points I'm gonna be going over today is, number 1, price. Obviously, we already talked about that. Number 2, effectiveness, and whether or not it is heavy duty or whatever it is. Basically, what this means is, when I'm talking about heavy duty, I am talking about wearing false lashes. There's a difference between everyday makeup and you're not wearing false lashes and you're just having your, you know, foundation, mascara, blah, 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 and that, versus a heavy makeup day. Example, whenever I film a YouTube video, I usually stick on a false lash. And usually this will include magnetic glue or eyelash glue. And so I'm gonna be talking about which cleansing oils are good for those and those days. And then lastly, I don't know why this is such an important factor for me personally, but the smell slash consistency. I think the best way personally for me to do this review is kind of just like categorize everything in bunches, because I'm not gonna talk about each and every single product in major detail, or we could actually be here forever. I'm just gonna start talking about the more heavy duty cleansing oils that I find. So right off the bat, I feel like the number one, this is by the way, all my opinion, as are all my videos, but you know, I just feel like I have to say this in case people are like, no, it's not, or whatever, but whatever. Okay, so in my opinion, the most heavy duty and the most effective one in terms of removing everything, including your false lashes, magnetic glue, whatever, is number 1, the Tatcha cleansing oil. I don't have it with me. I finished it a long time ago. The Tatcha cleansing oil, it is $62 Canadian. I will also have the American prices here as well. It is $62 Canadian at 150 milliliters. It prices at 0.41 cents per milliliter. So kind of on the pricey side, because a lot of the cleansing oils we're gonna go through today are all 150 milliliters. So this one is priced at $62. So this is a little bit pricey. It is actually the second most pricey one. The 2 most expensive cleansing oils are the Tatcha and this Guilin one. So this one right here, this one is even more expensive than Tatcha. This one is $76 at 150 milliliters and the Tatcha one is $62 at 150 milliliters. So in my opinion, both work really, really, really great. It removes my lash glue and magnetic eyeliner extremely effectively. And when I say effectively, I'm talking about speed and the number of times I have to repump. These two, although very expensive, they're honestly also the most heavy duty ones. The other reason why I really like this one in particular for the Guerlain one is because this one also, I feel like, has a lot of these properties that are very, very rare. So why this is expensive is because it's using a lot of these rare properties from the special island. I actually attended their conference and stuff, so I actually learned about it. They use very special ingredients for this one, hence why the product is so expensive. For these two particular products, honestly, whether or not it's worth the price, yes, but if you are an everyday eyelash wearer, 100%, these two need to be like your everyday makeup remover. However, if you are an occasional one like me, honestly, I would buy this to use it on the days that you have heavier makeup days, because there are cheaper ones that can help you remove your everyday makeup, and then maybe have this one just on the days that it's a little bit more heavy duty. Not saying that it can't be used interchangeably, but I'm just talking about, you know, what is like the best bang for your buck here. Another one that actually is surprisingly good at removing eyelash glue and stuff is actually this Shu Uemura brand. I think that's how you pronounce it. So this cleansing oil is surprisingly also very good at removing eyelash glue and stuff like that. I think my one and only complaint is that the cleansing oil itself is very, very, very watery. So I find that I usually have to pump out a little bit more than usual. As you guys can see, in the 1 month or two that I've been here, I've already used up about half. This one's actually very much on the cheap side, as it should be because you're using more. This one at 150 milliliters, so the same as the two that I just mentioned, is actually only priced at $33, so 22 cents per milliliter. This is on my chart, and I have ranked this in price. On my chart, this is the cheapest of the 9 that I will be talking about today. So take that information as you will. If you want to try out the cheapest one, this one would be it in my list of the ones that I've tried. So that was kind of like my heavy duty one. I think the ones that I find that are everyday practical ones personally are Amore Pacific, Dermalogica, Shiseido, and Kiehl's. So I will leave each of the pictures up here for you. Out of these 4 brands that I've tried and mentioned, once again, not going to be talking about each exact one. So I'm just really going to narrow down kind of my top. I also have the Caudalie one on the list as well. But to be honest, after trying the Caudalie one, it is not my favorite. And although I love and advocate for every other product in this brand, and you guys know this, I have tried and loved like 10 or 20 of their products, and I love this brand. The one thing that I did not fall in love with was their cleansing oil, even though it is quite moderately priced. It is $34 at 150 milliliters. So it is literally in the middle range of this entire list. However, for me, the consistency was not my favorite. I heard from a couple other bloggers that they had the same sentiment. However, I do also know people that love this cleansing oil. You know, take it as you will. The price is literally in the middle of everything that I mentioned. Actually, the most expensive, this is the cheapest. So Caudalie one is right in between these two. So once again, take that information as you will. Personally, I'm not the biggest fan of the consistency. I think that it was a little bit thicker than I'm used to, and it takes me a lot longer to rub my makeup off. That's my personal review. I actually did talk to the PR team about this product and my own review on this, so they are aware, but I think they also had some mixed feedback, people loving it and some people not liking it. So I think this one's gonna be personal preference. So anyway, going back to the other ones that I mentioned, Dermalogica, Amore Pacific, Kiehl's, and Shiseido, out of these 4, honestly, the performance in all of them are more or less the same. I think in terms of effectiveness, I think at this point, what I care about after the performance, meaning removing your makeup and stuff, after that, all I care about is packaging, the smell, and also the residue that it leaves later on your skin. So coming at number 1, the Amore Pacific Human Cleansing Oil. And like I said from the very beginning of this video, this is the first cleansing oil that I've ever purchased in my life. And since then, I have purchased maybe about 10 more. I'm not even joking you. I have probably purchased this not just for myself. I bought this for my mom a while ago, and sometimes I use it now. I actually went through their product change as well. Their product change before used to be as tall as this, and it used to be a lot more narrow at the bottom, which was such a not smart design because it would tip over all the time. time. And the amount of times I have tipped over my cleansing oil and lost half of the oil, oh, it killed me. When they switched to this package, I was like, thank you, God, thank you. Because I was struggling with the old packaging. Now it is absolutely amazing. The smell is by far, out of the four that I had mentioned, the best. The smell is unreal. Well, for me anyway. And then in terms of the effectiveness and the residue, just absolutely perfect. Like I said, this was the one where I would just use this and not use any other product later. In terms of price, this one is priced at $65. But at 200 milliliters. So it comes at 0.325 cents per milliliter, slightly higher than the Caudalie, which was right in the middle, smack middle. So this one is just slightly higher. The other three, so the Dermalogica, the Kiehl's, and the Shiseido one, all are really good. I think for me, this is just me being picky now because, like I said, I've tried 9. So I'm allowed to pick a favorite, okay? Out of those three, personally, the Dermalogica one, I think for me, the smell of it is very like earthy, like you smell like you're going to a spa, kind of like aroma, like you're going to the spa type of like essential oil, that smell. So that's the smell you're gonna get. When being compared to this one, I prefer this smell, but if you guys are into the spa smell, I would go with the Dermalogica one. That one's a little bit more expensive at $63 at 150 milliliters, so it's gonna be slightly more expensive than this bottle. The other two that I mentioned, Kiehl's and Shiseido, honestly, those two to me didn't really stand out in any way. And that's not a bad thing because, like I said, the Caudalie one stood out to me because of the consistency. And I was like, whoa, I'm not used to this. The Shiseido and the Kiehl's one actually didn't stand out like good or bad. I think they were all just kind of meh. They worked well, like didn't particularly smell the best, but at the same time, it worked. And I think those are also very good for every day. Not so much like heavy duty, but it's good for your everyday one. And those two are actually priced even better. Those two are actually right above this one in terms of the price. The Shiseido is actually $46 at 180 milliliters. So that brings it to 25 cents per milliliter. And the Kiehl's one is $42 for $175. So 0.24 cents per milliliter. Basically, I think that my overall review is the one that I will always continue buying over and over again in terms of every day is probably this one here. However, this is not the cheapest option. If you guys are not too picky about the smell and stuff like that, I honestly would just go with some of the cheaper ones, with Shiseido and the Kiehl's one. And if you guys need anything heavy duty, I would actually spend the money on a pricier product. So this one, or even the Tatcha one, this one I would actually consider. I've been using it for a really long time now. I would just buy it due to the price. You are using a little bit more product. So I haven't done the analysis on, you know, how many times I'm gonna use this and whether or not the price ends up being worth it, because you end up pumping a lot more. Yeah, so anyway, take this review as you will, but I think the two that really come on top for me is this one and also this one for heavy duty. If you guys want, I have also listed the items of the cleansing oils in order of price down below, so you guys are able to check it out. But that is pretty much my review for the cleansing oils, and I hope you guys also enjoyed the first part of the video on why you should be using this method in how to wash your face. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye!